Hey everyone, it's Connor. I hope everyone enjoyed the National Barbecue Day yesterday. I had tons of awesome vegan food. I know I did. But what I wanted to do today, I had actually done this video yesterday, and it somehow got deleted. It never got uploaded. And I also wanted to try something like a Media Monday where I find something in my local media that is kind of like important and should be brought to the attention of like the national media, only because you want people to be aware of certain things. You want certain people who think that, oh, it's 2016 and certain things can't happen anymore or won't happen anymore because we're past that, you know, and it's not. Just because it's 2016 doesn't mean that, you know, something is, you know, is dead now, you know. So what I wanted to talk about was how there was a man from the UAE here in Ohio. I live in Ohio. And he was checking into a hotel. He was on his cell phone. He had multiple cell phones. And the clerk, apparently the clerk's sister, who was like at the hotel, called the police and said she heard the man on his cell phone pledge allegiance to ISIS. So, it's in the national news now. I actually saw it last night and I'm like, but good, because you know, it's a good thing, because it's something that should be out there. It's super sad. The reality of it is super sad, because she completely judged him on his lack of English and because of the way he's dressed. And honestly, that can happen to anybody in any country, anywhere, okay? We, as Americans, can wear blue jeans and a white t-shirt and travel to another country where we don't know the language and they barely speak English there, and people could assume the worst of us as well, you know? But 9 times out of 10, they really don't, like, I don't know. So, the man was actually here because Ohio is one of the best medical systems in the world, believe it or not, especially when it comes to heart care and things of that nature. The Cleveland Clinic is huge, and people from the Middle East come here all the time for medical care, to the point where Cleveland Clinic is opening a campus in either, I think it's Abu Dhabi. It's either Abu Dhabi or Dubai, but I think it's Abu Dhabi. And the man had suffered a stroke in April. He was here for medical care. So last Wednesday, he was, you know, taken down by police. You know, and it's not the police's fault. They were just doing, this is a situation where you can say they were just doing their job. It really is that woman who has been, you know, succumbed by fear-mongering, that a person who looks this way is dangerous, and if you see them, you should say something, kind of a deal. I say in that nature, it's kind of hard to draw the line who's dangerous and who's not when you're just looking at clothing, kind of a deal. So this will be a topic for later to go more in-depth about. But it's something, it's sad. I do feel sad for that man, because it's something that people in the black community deal with a lot. A lot. Okay. How they tell us you won't be targeted if you dress a certain way, you know? And that's simply not true. We were wearing suits and we were still lynched, you know? What you wear doesn't matter. At the end of the day, it's all about the mentality of the other person. It's not about what you have on. And that's it. I know I personally have dealt with something along those lines only because of what I wear. I wear a head wrap. I wear certain types of clothes. I wear certain types of jewelry. And people assume that I'm Muslim. People assume that I'm from a certain part of the world, and they give me certain looks, they tell me certain things, they don't want me to stay in their store too long. I'm looking at my phone and they're like hounding me down, like, why is she looking at her phone? So it's interesting, and it's so what's ultimately sad is that their government has sent out tweets urging people and sent out notices in the paper and on television urging their citizens, don't wear your traditional clothing when you travel abroad, because even in parts of Europe, like, wearing the veil that some women wear is banned. And they're urging people, don't do it because you're going to get hurt and, you know, it's all right. So I know for some people they wear that for religious reasons. So now at this point, for a lot of people, it's like, well, I'm not going to travel. Like, why do I have to be this way? It's not meant for me to travel. It's just not. Some people aren't going to compromise on their religious standards. So now they can't travel. Not that they can't, but they won't. Now they won't travel. They don't feel safe enough to travel. And that's sad. That you feel that you should stay at home to be safe just based on clothes. And another thing that I was thinking of, that 9 times out of 10 these people wear these certain garments because of the climate that they live in. Now I guess a lot of people don't realize that living in the desert, when you live in the desert all your life, when you live in the Middle East, when you live in hot, dry climate, it's best for you to wear the clothes that they wear, to be covered altogether, because the sun is out so much. The heat, the wind, when the wind blows, it hurts the sand. Just the heat in general, it hurts. It's hot, okay? So yes, I'm gonna wear long sleeves, okay? When it's summertime, you know, it looks strange, but it's actually ingenious, super ingenious, and it makes sense. They do it in Africa as well. Anywhere where it's like super hot, no one's gonna be out in booty shorts and a tank top, you know. That's not it's not productive, you know. You wear these long robes, you wear veils, you wear headscarves to protect your body, to protect yourself, to protect your health. Yes, because you're covered from the air, the sun is bouncing off of the colors. Believe it or not, black is not really that hot, okay? I know people who wear hoods in the summer because it blocks the sun. You look like you're on drugs, but you're really pretty smart because it's blocking the sun, it's blocking wind and heat. And that's just the truth. That's just what it is. So I think it's people being fearful, people being miseducated about why someone wears what they wear. They assume it's religious, and it can be both religious and both cultural, because a lot of times religion is part of their culture. But a lot of the times there are Christians in the Middle East, and they're wearing this. They dress like this. Why? Because it's the Middle East and it's hot. You know, it's to the climate. They're dressing to the climate. And if you live there, because a lot of people ask, well, if they travel, why don't they just wear different clothes? Well, if you live in a certain climate all your life, you're only going to have a certain style of clothing. So when you go to travel, those are your clothes. Those are your clothes. And if you're comfortable in that, if you like that, that's what you're going to buy. And that's okay. You know, you don't see, you know, people in other countries telling Americans when they travel, hey, get some German clothes, make sure you get some Thai clothes, make sure you get some other clothes when you're over here. How come you came to Singapore and you didn't bring, you know, and you're wearing American clothes? Why'd you do that? No one's asking you to do that. So yes, sadness. At the end of the day, I just want people to educate themselves on clothing, especially when it comes to extreme climates. Educate yourself on clothing and stop being a sheeple. A sheepson. I don't know. Just stop being fear-mongered at the end of the day. If you hear something and it's scary, okay, be scared. But use the energy of your fear to further educate yourself so that you don't have to be afraid. My parents always told me that preparation is always the best offense to fear. If you're scared, first of all, you really don't have to be scared of anything. But if you are, prepare yourself so that you're not. And then you can fully tackle the situation safely and effectively. Which would have been great for this woman. First of all, she should have just left them alone. Like, seriously, it was just because she didn't understand what the man was saying on his cell phone. And it's because he was wearing a robe and a veil. So, I don't know. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. Please stay tuned. I think I'm going to keep going with this Monday media thing. And maybe one day it'll actually end up on a Monday and not a Tuesday. Follow me on Instagram at ConReezyBeats. Follow me on Tumblr at passport2pangea.tumblr.com. If you feel so bold, you can add me on Facebook at Connor Speedner. Shoot me a message. Comment down below what you think. Shoot me a message about any questions or any other content you guys would think would be interesting that a black, vegan, female living in America could bring perspective to. And yes, all of those do matter for those of you who are wondering. Why does all of those things matter? They do matter. Because all of those in my life bring a different perspective about how I see everything. So, yes. Comment on Instagram. Message me on Tumblr. Check it out. And that's it. Alright guys, bye.